Alright guys, what's going on? My name is Ragnarokka, and we are here. So, this is literally the minute that the Pokemon Direct has just ended, and I want to give my own initial thoughts, reactions, and things of that nature. So, first thing they just talked about off the bat, they said, we're excited to talk about a Pokemon game for the Switch, and I was like, no, don't do this. No, they're not doing this, are they? And then Pokken Tournament DX. Personally, I've never really enjoyed Pokken Tournament, never played it too much. It's kind of, there. And a cool couple new characters, including Decidueye, which I think is probably the coolest. It's just nice to include a Gen 7 Pokemon into it. It's clear that Nintendo kind of wants to push Pokken, but I don't know, it's just never really been. Maybe just I preferred Smash, so. You could get on supporting that instead, they brought that to this, brought Pokken to the Switch instead of Smash first. That's great. Love it. Oh dear. I was just like, why? Did it need to be necessary? Why can't they just include it in an update or something on the Wii U? I don't know. But we have it now. We've got Pokken for the Switch on September 22nd. The second thing they announced, which I thought that's what they do in the trailer, Pokemon Ultra Sun and Pokemon Ultra Moon. We are getting secondary games for the 3DS for Sun and Moon. Boy. So yeah, that's instead of getting DP remakes, which I mean, I prefer DP. It gives them more time to perfect the game. yeah. So Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon is happening, guys. And those legendaries. Oh my god, they look badass as hell. What can I say? It looks badass. It's, we got a cool couple new animations, including Togemaru and Mimikyu, which is an interesting couple of choices. Togemaru is seeing a lot of play in VGC right now. And Mimikyu is much better as a singles Pokemon, but I think can see some play in VGC. Kind of interesting they went with those two. I guess they are the two Pikachu clones, so eh. They didn't really show off a lot of gameplay. They showed us the bit of the start of the game, which we knew because we played Pokemon Sun and Moon. Which they say it's an alternate story. That makes me believe it's gonna be more like Platinum. So it's an alternate story like that. Platinum or Emerald, things like that. Instead of what they did with Black and White 2, which was a continuation of the story. Which I wouldn't mind either, This also means we get Lily back, which is good, because I like Lily a lot. I like her character. So and then, last but not least, which I only got pointed to me out, only got pointed out to me yesterday, is like they could actually release Gen 2 on the freaking Virtual Console. I was like, oh my god, if they did, and they did. Gold and Silver are on the Virtual Console on the 22nd of September. Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon are on November 17th. Completely forgot I didn't say that. Gold and Silver on. I love Gold and Silver. Gold was my first Pokemon game. And they are bank compatible when downloaded on the Virtual Console, so that's really cool. I get to play Pokemon Gold and Silver. For everyone who like didn't have their, have their batteries just dried on their frigging cartridges, I think mine included at this point. But yeah, so that's really cool. I will be more than happy to get Gold or Silver. Probably Silver. I don't know. But yeah, so. Yay, that's really cool. But yeah, talking about my bit more on Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon. I guess I could talk about a little bit of what I'd want from it. I don't really know, to be honest. Like, just something more, I suppose. I don't know what they could add or what I'd want them to add. Mainly because I've only beaten Pokemon Moon once. And every time I try to go back and play it, it just feels stale, even after just one playthrough. I don't know. It was enjoyable the first time around, and then just I can't go back and play it for some reason. I've not finished my Pokemon Sun. Yet with X and Y, well, X I've beaten like four times. So clearly there's something right there. So I think mainly one of the things was the start of the game of Sun and Moon was very, very hand-holdy. I mean, that's why it kind of turned me off. The start of the game and a lot of the game in general is kind of hand-holdy until you get to the really late portions and then it becomes really good. But like a lot of the game is just kind of like, you need to do this or you need to do that. So maybe just tone down the hand-holdiness of the game. That's probably one of my biggest complaints with the original Sun and Moon. Maybe it's just one of the reasons why I can't go back and play it as much. But yeah. Other than that, I don't know, maybe expand the Pokédex a little bit. Be nice. Always nice to have a bit of a different Pokédex. There's 300 Pokémon, which is great and all. 300's a lot. But X and Y had 450. When there are only 718. And in Sun and Moon, you were, I think, at 812 total. And you included 302 if you count Meganer and Marshadow, which obviously Marshadow's not released, but we obviously know about it. So, yeah. That, you know, it may be even just 50 or so. I mean, you look how much of a difference 60 made on friggin'. Yeah, I'm gonna bring this up a lot because Gen 4 is my favorite gen. Diamond and Pearl to Platinum. Look how much of a difference that 60 Pokemon made back when there was 493. But yeah, there's 60 Pokemon they added in the main Pokedex. And most of them were actually just Pokemon that you could only get in the after game for Diamond and Pearl. Just added them and a few extra cool ones, and it's like, oh yeah, this is suddenly like incredibly good. So, you know, just add a couple new Pokemon that are cool. But honestly, the first thing that comes to mind for me is, for some reason, Scizor. I don't know why, but, you know, adding a couple things like that. You know, it could be really cool just to have some older Pokemon. There are a lot of Pokemon in the game I liked. Also, yeah, I guess more Alola forms, I guess. We could have more Alola forms. Maybe not just stick them to Gen 1. There's a lot of things that you could do with the Alolan forms and just haven't explored because they're only Gen 1. You know, things like Ludicolo and Lilligant come to mind. You know, they could easily get Alolan forms. You know, or there's a lot of different Pokemon out there that could get Alolan forms. Could give Roserade Alolan forms and hint to, you know, the boy Gen 4 remakes. But, yeah, we could have more. So, yeah, please, give us something more. That's all we're at. I'd say that's all we're asking for, but more Alolan forms could be nice, or just more Pokemon in general, to expand the variety of the Pokedex. Definitely felt a lot of the game was just like, the early game was very linear, so. Maybe just make the early game not as linear, and, you know, expand on the Pokedex a little bit, you know. Like I say, you don't have to add many. 50 or so will do. I don't really have any speculations on what could be happening with the legendaries, barring the fact that, oh, they could have been taken over by Ultra Beasts. You know, because it is called Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, and they do have that weird, like, effect on them that, Nihilego had when, well, it took over Lusamine. If you're watching this, then I assume you're playing Pokemon Sun and Moon. So yeah. It's a lot to look forward to, and there's going to be a lot in the coming months about this game. Am I going to be looking forward to it? Hell to the yes. I'm going to buy it because I love Pokemon for a reason. So yeah. But for now, I shall see you guys next time. Take it easy.